This is a monitor from AOC. It has a glossy screen and a thin bezel design which makes it look really sleek. The only problem is, it's faulty. I was browsing through some dollar reserve auction and bid on a monitor with a known fault. It said the screen turns on, but it will only display a white screen. Here is the symptom. I placed a dollar bid, forgotten about it, and turned out, no one else bid. So I won. Here is a short video of how I've repaired this monitor. To remove the rear panel, remove two metal screws. The center one doesn't need to be removed, and it's a pain to get to. I didn't know at the time, so I've removed it anyway. You need to work around the edge patiently with a plastic pick to separate the panel. If you use a screwdriver, you'd likely to dent it. Removing this panel was a little tricky, as I couldn't find anything on the internet for this particular model. Hope this can be a good guide for someone tackling the same task on the same monitor. Once you get the upper portion of the panel loose, make your way around the bottom edge of the screen. The bottom part is held quite firmly, but with a bit of persuasion, it will come apart. As you can see, four capacitors blew and leaked out electrolytes. More than half the problem associated with the monitor is from blown capacitors. I'm going to replace these with what I have in my parts bin. Otherwise, you can buy capacitors from your local electronic component store for a few dollars. I'm skipping the soldering stage in this video, but you'd also need a solder station. To get to the board, you'd need to remove the housing. Carefully lift off the tape that secures LCD cable to the panel. Remove two speakers and put them aside. Be careful when removing ribbon connectors. Lift the tab upwards before pulling on the ribbon. Remove screws that secure output connectors to the housing. Pry off the LCD connector using a flathead screwdriver. Now gently lift the housing off. While you're there, it pays to clean the LCD connector with alcohol, as they tend to corrode over time. Cleaning it will be good preventative maintenance. This is how a bulged capacitor looks like after I've cleaned the residue. The capacitor I had was of higher voltage rating, which I salvaged from a dead TV some time ago. Remember, using a higher voltage rated capacitor is fine, as long as you keep to the same capacitance. It was a little too long for the overall design, so I've installed it sideways. When it comes to electrons, physical appearance doesn't matter. They just need to flow. Once capacitors are all soldered in place, reassembly is a breeze. After PCB parts are put back, the rear panel can basically be snapped back on. Reinstall screws for HDMI and VGA connectors. Slide the housing back onto the panel. Connect the LCD ribbon cable. Reapply the tape. Connect two side ribbon connectors. Mount two speakers back on the housing. Don't place the rear plastic panel before testing the monitor. No point screwing all the bolts in if it doesn't work. You can kind of see the reflection in the video that the monitor worked. Now I can safely go ahead and finish off reassembly. Okay, so this was the story behind how I bought 24-inch monitor for $1. If you've liked this video, there will be more videos like this uploaded on this channel, so subscribe and stay tuned.